I grew up in Chippenham, so southwestern Sydney. I wanted to be a pilot originally. I always would change what I wanted to do every year or so. I didn't get into engineering until probably like last 2 years of high school. I studied mechatronics and robotics engineering at UWS, now WSU. Basically, the whole entire solar car program came about from a final year engineering project that Dr. Ali Halani put together. It was just one line out of the list of projects you could choose. It was a group project for four people, and he was telling me it would be this very, very ambitious project to build a small electric runabout on the campus. And I'd heard of the World Solar Challenge before, and I thought that was maybe what it might be about. We met and we tried to think about how we would design this and do it, and I thought, hey, let's use the rules from the World Solar Challenge. That's when we started designing a solar car. And through 2011, in my final year, that is when the first iteration, the first three-wheel version of the car sort of came to being, and when we started proposing doing the project with School of Engineering. I started with $500 of funding, and we were raising money through selling sausage sandwiches on campus. Things didn't really start getting momentum until we started signing our first sponsors. And when other people started handing us cash, that's when others started noticing. We started getting a little bit more legitimacy. There was a pre-Sol Ace car that we built in 2012 that was a hunk of junk. We sort of took that to the open day, and it was nothing but a bare bone carbon body and a chassis with some wheels attached that we stole from a wrecker. The real solar car didn't start truly getting built until March 2013, so the year of the race. It was a hard run up, and we didn't actually get to do any testing. By the time it hit the road, it had done less than 50 kilometers of testing and ended up driving nearly 3,000 Ks based on that. So a lot of our early assumptions were pretty good when we designed the car in terms of reliability, which was nice. It did reasonably well. It had its own mechanical issues. It wasn't as efficient as we wanted it to be. I mean, it was our first car. It was our first run. Toward the end, we started getting really heavy weather. So we got like 70 kilometer per hour headwinds and lots of overcast and stuff like that. So we ended up, I made the decision to just trailer the car. We brought it in on the Saturday and did our first World Solar Challenge and positioned 11th. For most people, it's a once-in-a-lifetime thing to do, like to participate in that race. But to run your own team, participate as the team manager and that sort of thing has its own unique set of challenges. It gave me an appreciation for what it's like to actually try and lead a group of people. I'm engineering project manager for Tesla Energy. There's lots of solar car alumni at Tesla. I got to make a lot of good connections, a lot of people, other teams, companies, all that sort of thing, and meet a lot of really valuable friends that have helped me out today. And a lot of those lessons have stuck with me. And they also affect how I like work professionally now.